What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Got a little bit of a different video today. Got my HasLab Proton Pack here. This one's completely modded out with a always-on mod. I got a voltmeter mod, all kinds of stuff. But today we're gonna be installing what's in this box right here. And for those that don't know what this is, it is a Ninja Tunes replacement board for the HasLab Proton Packs. Got a nice set of instructions here from Konstantinos from Ninja Tunes. I got a kit here that he sent me, and I told him I'd make a video for this. So we're gonna go disassemble my HasLab Proton Pack, take it all apart, and show you what's inside the kit and how it installs into the Proton Pack. First in the kit, got this cool little Ninja Tunes sticker. Put that right there. This is a new volume potentiometer that we are gonna use right here. One, two, three bags of goodies. Oh, look down in here in the bottom. We have another Slimer sticker. So that's pretty cool there. Inside the box, get my knife and be careful not to cut things. We'll open this one first. This is the main board. The main replacement board, which goes in place of the main board in the HasLab pack. And the way that he sends this is in two pieces. So this is piece one, this is the base plate. It's also got a 3D printed surround, which will mount in the original location. And then over here is the second half of the main board. This is where all the factory connectors will go in, all color coded. And yeah, so all you gotta do is make sure you line up these connectors right in here and snap it right on in. Just like so. And then now we are ready to pull out the third package right here. And here you have some ribbon cable. I can get it in there. Ribbon cable. You have the power cell. This is the, I believe this is the Gen 2 power cell, this the black one. I couldn't really tell you the difference between this one and the other one. You'd have to go look at the Ninja Tunes website and actually see what that is. And then over here, this last little piece in here is the vent relay. So this will go down into the board. You have your vent in, or two vent in, more power, and this will connect in through the ribbon cable. This also controls the cyclotron cake mod that they made. And it's pretty cool. Again, I'll link down in the description to all the parts that Konstantinos has got, as well as he's got a pretty substantial PDF here of how to install all the parts. So we're gonna walk you through that right now. So here's a quick little tip. The main board on the Ninja Tunes kit takes 12 volts, and it's required because there's an onboard amplifier in here that needs the extra power. If you're buying a Talon cell and you've had the one with the USB plug running 5 volts to the original HasLab board, it also comes with this adapter. Usually it's for charging, but you can use it as a jumper. You plug it into the barrel connector on the Talon cell, turn it on. You can also plug it in to the barrel plug here on the Ninja Tunes board. Power light lights up. So this could be your power cable from your Talon cell. Pretty simple. Now we got to go in and take off all the back screws for the original motherboard. We'll put the motherboard off to the side. All right, so in the instructions supplied by Ninja Tunes, we have our parts list, main board with the secondary board that's attached together, already on the 3D printed mounting board, the volume knob, the relay for the cyclotron cake, and vent kit, ribbon cable, and then the power cell. This is the black version that I have. And if you've got a little bit of breakdown, you have the green version power cell, the black version power cell. And this shows you how to mount the two boards together, make sure they lock in like we already showed you. And it's got some call-out instructions, shows you where everything goes. So in the top half here, this board here is gonna get replaced. And then a volume knob is below the speaker. And then you can mount the relay board down in here if you really wanted to. And first thing we're gonna have to do, according to the instructions, are we're gonna need to remove the stock green board and remove the speaker. Now on my speaker, I've already removed the original one. I cut the wires and I installed a JST connector. So that's just gonna be my version there to unplug, and we'll unplug everything else here. Unplug. There's the switch. All the goodies, and then the green one. Everything's all off there, and now we gotta remove the screws way down there to get my speaker out. The whole tray's gotta come off. I gotta find a nice long screwdriver here. Just slides on out. So if anybody's wondering, I believe I got this file for the 3D print for the speaker on one of the stock sites. I want to say it was GitHub. And then I got this giant speaker. It's an 8-ohm speaker, replaces the factory 8-ohm speaker. Gives it a lot more bass, a lot more depth. I really like this add-on, so I'll leave some links down below for that. Then I can get my screw out. I'm gonna leave that with my speaker for now. So we're gonna be putting that back in afterwards. And now we got to go ahead, and if you were not like me, you have the original speaker, you're going to cut the wire off the main board, and we're going to take the main board and the potentiometer for the crank generator volume off. And he's got instructions here on how to do all that, so you just got to follow through. We've already got my speaker out of the way. Right, so we have to take off the board here for the back, the crank generator, which is AKA the volume knob. That comes right on out. And then our main board will just unscrew with these two screws. And these are shorter than the other two we just took out, so keep that in mind. Main board and stock parts going away. All right, so now we have all this out of the way. We can take our new volume knob. We can make sure we can line it up inside the holes down inside here from the crank generator. It only goes in one way. So we're just gonna line it. So the flat part is facing down. The same thing here, the flat part is gonna face towards the wires. Make sure we get that right in there. Then we can control the volume right there. And we'll just screw it in. Make sure you're not over tightening it. You don't want to crack the 3D printed material or damage any of the components. It's just snug, so there's no play in there. Perfect, and we'll check. And we've got plenty of movement there. Perfect. All right. I'm gonna go put my speaker back in, and then again, this is the modified version of the speaker assembly I have. It's a good idea to start these screws ahead of time. It'll save you from trying to get them dropped back in there, lined up. Speakers in, volume knob is in, on to the next page. All right, so here's the main board already assembled, two pieces together. And on mine, I'm gonna spin it 180 degrees from the instructions, only because I have this larger speaker and I won't be able to fit the power connector in, which is over on this side. We'll screw it on in. And now on your stock pack, you can go ahead and connect everything back up, just as the color coding would show you. Switch one, right over here, and then everything else is pretty much plug and play by the colors. Switch for the volume goes right in the middle. Red. I modified my wand cable, so this is my purple connector. There. And with your stock speaker, you got the port here where you can plug in. Since I've modified mine, I have a JST connector, which I'll connect. Just make sure you follow the color codes. Plug my speaker in. Just tuck all these out of the way. We'll run this wire underneath them all, just because it's longer. Pull it down. All right, so now everything is technically hooked up. Oh, I forgot my green wire. All right, so now everything is hooked up except for the power cell. We're gonna go ahead and take that apart right now so we can show you how to put the new power cell in. Flip the pack around so I have some better access to it. And I'm just gonna un-Velcro my always on mod. So this is what I was running for the always on before. You don't have to worry about that anymore because this pack will run as intended and not shut down. And now to remove the power cell. First thing we're going to do is take off our booster tubes on the side here. So you do that by these two screws right through the side. All right, so once these two screws are out, you have two more screws on the inside that hold the booster on, and that's where it's going to come in handy to have a right angle screwdriver. All right, so we'll move the booster tube out of the way and then take off the remaining two screws for the power cell lens cover. And if I don't drop screws everywhere. So here is the original power cell that came with the HasLab pack. We're gonna need to take this one out and we're gonna have to cut these little plastic, they're plastic welded in there so that lens stays in there. So we'll pop those out and pop the new lens in. What I'm using here is just a pair of sideways cutters just to kind of snap the plastic. Does that come out now? A little bit left on this one here in the corner. Should be able to pop this out. Take off our little ferrite here. This is just to block the signal. Must have had some type of weird signal thing going on from the factory. There he is. Power cell separated from the housing. Now we will slide the new power cell in, keeping in mind the direction that we need to go. And it's pretty straightforward. There's arrows on the cell lens that points up, and we know that when we put it in, up is on this side here. So now that I've got the power cell all lined up in here, arrow points up, towards the top. We want to make sure we get that in right, so when we put it in, your power cell goes the right way. And I'm just going to hot glue the edges where we pop the plastic off. Just drop a couple little dabs in each one so we know it doesn't go anywhere. Then we can put our power cell back together and continue on. And now we can hook the cable back up here for the power cell. And tape this to the side here just so it stays out of the way when I put the cover back on the back. Then the last thing all we need to add is the relay for the cake mod or the vent, whichever you choose. I don't have any of those options now, but I am just gonna Velcro it to the tabs inside here just to kind of prepare me for when I do make those mods. There. Here's our ribbon cable. Here's the ribbon cable. And I'm just gonna kind of stick it in here for a later use. And I'm not gonna bother hooking it up right now, but we would just track it through here and plug it back into the black connector there. Again, I don't have anything to run off of it right now, so I'm just gonna kind of leave it idle for the time being. What's cool is Ninja Tunes gives you this little addition right here. If you remove this red connector, there is a pin combination for a JST connector, which you could run to a switch. And some people are running the switch underneath the pack here to that underneath side of where that crank generator is for the hidden on-off switch. So now we just got to kind of reassemble the booster tubes, flip it over, hook the wand up, and we'll do a quick demonstration. So here's the moment of truth. The demonstration of the HasLab Proton Pack with the Ninja Tunes kit installed. First thing we're gonna do is make sure both of our toggle switches are pointed up. That's gonna be our standard 1984 Ghostbusters mode. Flip the switch down there underneath the ion arm. You got your standard power cell lights lighting. And we'll go ahead and flip one, two, and then a third activate. Now pop it out, and after 15 seconds, it will go into an overheat mode. The pack will restart. The wand is still in its factory settings. It will shut down after that overheat mode, but the pack will restart and run indefinitely. Pack starts back up, cyclotron cycling. It's also got the ribbon cable running. All right, flip it down to power it off. All right, so now we're gonna flip it into afterlife mode. Take our cyclotron lid off. Toggle switch number one is gonna flip down, and we'll flip our switch back on the IR arm. Hey, what's going on? Editor Craig here, jumping in real quick for 1 second. I was noticing while putting the video together that the way the cyclotron looked on the video didn't look like it did in real life. The lighting in my garage and the frame rate of the camera was a little bit off, so it didn't look quite right. You can see behind me both the ride packs here running the Ninja Tunes kits are both operating, and you can see how the cyclotron works and looks a little bit different. These do have diffused lens covers, just so you know. That's a little bit different than the actual video, but this is what it really looks like. Back to the video. This is where all the cool sounds come from. Cyclotron is cycling. Now listen to these sounds. Thank you. goes in the vent mode. Pack's going to restart back up, start cycling. Wand is again shut down, still factory settings, nothing changes with that. So the wand does nothing other than control all the functions. Once it shuts down, the pack still operates as normal. And we have the ribbon cable warning. Now, the third feature is jukebox mode. Both toggle switches are down. We will repower our pack and control it from switch number one of the wand here. Once you flip it up, the song will start playing. Flip it back down, wait 4 seconds, flip it up again, and you can switch the songs. Standard Ghostbusters theme comes on first. Count to four. 1, 2, 3, 4. Flip the switch again. Change the songs, and it'll continue all the way through whatever you have preloaded on the SD card. NinjaTunes supplies it with plenty of songs in there, but you can change them if you want. All in the instructions here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ghostbusters! And they take it out of jukebox mode, just flip switch number two up. Now you're back in afterlife mode. There you have it. Check out NinjaTunes. Instructions are here. I'll link everything down below. It's a pretty simple setup. It's an awesome addition to your HasLab Proton Pack. We'll turn it down so you can hear me. Thanks for watching, and hopefully you enjoyed the tutorial.
Oh my God, the Scoleri brothers!